Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh has announced that border with Pakistan will be sealed by 2018. He said border security grid will be set up and there will be no compromise with the country's security. Earlier, Rajnath Singh reviewed security situation on western frontier in Jaisalmer in a meeting with leaders of four states bordering Pakistan, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Punjab and Jammu and Kashmir. BJP President Amit Shah slammed Arvind Kejriwal for doubting the surgical strike by Indian Army, saying those asking for proof are indirectly supporting Pakistan through his statements, even quoting a Twitter trend that reflects the same sentiment. BJP Chief Amit Shah slammed Rahul Gandhi for his remarks on surgical strikes, saying the Congress Vice President crossed all limits and insulted army and jawans by his comments. A day after three terrorists who tried to infiltrate the international border from POK had been gunned down by security forces at Handwara in North Kashmir, the National Investigation Agency has set up a 10 to 12 member team to begin probe into this infiltration bid. US Congresswoman Tulsi Gabbard has said Pakistan has continued to allow terrorist organizations to operate within their borders, moving across borders and unchecked and allowing access into India. She further said that people within the Pakistani government continue to provide overt support for terrorism. Union Information Broadcasting Minister Venkaiah Naidu met Goa Chief Minister Lakshmikant Parsekar in Goa's capital Panaji to review preparations for the 47th International Film Festival of India to be held in the state next month. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, currently on visit to the USA, chaired the Commonwealth Finance Ministers meeting at International Monetary Fund's headquarters in Washington, D.C. Issue of economics of climate change and financing climate adaptation and mitigation was discussed during the meeting. Supreme Court stayed Patna High Court's judgment quashing the Bihar government's law banning sale and consumption of all types of liquor in the state. A bench issued notices to all respondents, including some liquor manufacturers, on whose plea the High Court had held as illegal and unconstitutional the Nitish Kumar government's prohibition law and posted the matter for hearing after 10 weeks. The anti-corruption branch said that it has summoned Delhi Deputy Chief Minister Manish Sisodia for questioning in the case of alleged illegal recruitments at the Delhi Commission for Women. Sisodia will have to appear before the anti-graft unit on October 14th. The high-level technical team of officials from Water Resources Ministry is now in Karnataka visiting Kaveri Basin. The expert team constituted under direction from the Supreme Court will assess the ground realities in basin regions and submit a report to the Apex Court on 17th of this month. The Supreme Court has told BCCI not to give funds to state cricket associations who are not implementing Lodha panel recommendations. Supreme Court has directed 13 state associations who have already received funds would not spend the same unless they give undertaking that Lodha panel recommendation will be implemented unconditionally. Colombian President Juan Manuel Santos have won the coveted Nobel Peace Prize for year 2016. His selection has come as a surprise after Colombians voted no to an agreement Santos signed with FARC rebels to end 52 years of war. 64-year-old Santos began peace talks with the FARC in 2012 carried out in Havana. The Hurricane Matthew has left over 300 people dead in Haiti and has now weakened after pounding different parts of Bahamas. It is now heading towards the US coast of Florida. An emergency has been declared in Florida state. Highways in Florida and neighboring states clogged up with people streaming inland to escape the storm. India will take on South Africa in the second match of the Under-17 BRICS Cup in Goa. India lost the opening tie to Russia by a solitary goal and would be looking to open its account on the points table. South Africa will be playing their first game today. India all set to host the third edition of Kabaddi World Cup, billed as the biggest Kabaddi extravaganza with wide representation for the first time. 12 nations are participating for grand title in Ahmedabad.